Ultra Express.
Hi guys, what's up? Vince SP here. We're back. It's been a while, I know. But hey, let's get into it. 2024 is nearby, right? Only a few months to go. And then it will be election year for South Africans. One question, straight up, who you voting for? I know there's a big hoo-ha right now going on. You know, people don't know whether to give ANC another chance. Some are like, EFF, nah. Some are like, DA, nah. And then you have your Action SA. You have, you know, other parties that will be, you know, contesting 2024 national elections. Who are you voting for? Straight up, simple. Rovota next year. Next year, Rovota. Babu, how vote be angwena? Babu, Rovota. I know how vote. Rovota, Babu. So, general elections will be held in South Africa in 2024 to elect the new National Assembly as well as the provincial legislature in each province. You know, I think let us also make time to, you know, break down other issues, you know, pertaining to elections and everything. But for now, we are talking about which party will you be voting for. And also, what is that one service delivery that is close to your heart that you're saying, can they do this one religiously? Right? Because all, you know, as much as we can have a lot of parties, we also want service delivery from them. You know, that's the only thing that we are looking for. Service delivery only. So I have a few voice notes here. I want us to go through the voice notes so that we can hear what some of our citizens are going to vote for. Wena o votela mang? Have you already made your decision, or you are still going through that deciding phase? How sure with regards to who you'll be voting for? Are you also checking their manifestos? Will you be looking into that? Or you are just made a decision, or no, I'm going to vote for this party regardless, I'm going to be listening to their manifesto or not, right? So you can hit me up with your comment below and tell me who wena, which party will you be voting for. I have some voice notes here from my people. Let's hear gore bona ba votela mang. First one, Anonza.
Hi, I'd like to remain anonymous, and I appreciate the opportunity to contribute to your podcast. When it comes to service delivery, there are a few key areas I believe politicians should prioritize. First and foremost, I'd like to see a strong emphasis on the maintenance and improvement of our roads and infrastructure. These are the lifelines of our communities and play a crucial role in our daily lives. In addition to this, I believe in the utmost importance of providing quality healthcare and education for all citizens. Access to healthcare is not just the basic right, but it's essential for the well-being and prosperity of our society. Education, too, is the cornerstone of a bright and promising future for our youth. As for my political choice, I want to keep an open mind and evaluate the various options available before making a decision. I think it's essential to thoroughly research and consider the policies and track records of different parties to make an informed choice that aligns with my values and the needs of our community. Once again, thank you for giving me the opportunity to voice my opinion on your podcast, and I wish you the best of luck with your podcast.
Thank you, Mugel. Thank you, Mugel. Are infrastructure, quality healthcare, and also prioritizing on education. So that is some of the pointers that she mentioned. Then in terms of which party she'll be voting for, Ha sure, Bukele. She's still thinking about it. Next one, Arugwe.
Except Brayaka, Dintangdang. I will assist Piri. I'm going to vote for EFF and Nantriki Batwe 49. I'm voting for EFF.
Straight up, voting for the EFF, economic freedom fighters. So she's clear. Guys, Metia Maskral, you know, this has been an ongoing issue for years. I don't know what did he make. They came here, they made a big noise, you know, with a lot of cars and everything. But now it's all quiet, right? So Haman Skoral Water, that is what she is talking about, saying she's going to vote for the EFF. Next one, Arugwe.
Well, for me, I'm voting PA, Gaetan McKenzie and Kenny Gunene. Reason being is that there's no party for South Africans besides the PA, because I am excluded in so many parties that are there currently. So 2024, I'm voting PA because it represents me and the mandate, like, it's clear what they want and what they are for. So that's the only party I'm voting from.
Thanks.
Yeah, very much interesting. Is it Patriotic Alliance, PA? I think so. If I'm wrong, guys, I'm sorry. But I think it's the Patriotic Alliance. Yo, so he's saying he's voting for the PA. Yeah, Gaetan McKenzie. I never thought I would hear someone actually saying that they'll be voting for PA. And he says it speaks to him. It includes him. That's interesting, actually. You know, because of you want to unpack what he means by that. When you say they're talking to you, what is it that you're talking about exactly? Interesting. Next one.
Hi, my name is Ibe, and yes, I'll definitely be voting for the EFF. And if there's anything that they could definitely work on, it's infrastructure development. I would like to see improvement, especially in terms of like water and sanitation, especially in Hammanskraal, because that has been a nightmare. And I feel like if there's anything that they could put more effort in, it's improving in that, because yeah, so many years down the line, we are still struggling with water, and other parts of the community does not have like even proper storage and storage systems. So yeah, EFF, you have my vote if you only promise to get infrastructure development in order in the Hammanskraal community. Thank you so much.
Infrastructure, I think infrastructure is coming out a lot, you know, so that is what some are looking at. I want to play this one.
Eita, well, now, first of all, I don't even know who they are. I don't even know what their mandate is, because if you look at what they're supposed to do and they have not been able to deliver for so many years, I don't see how that's going to change. So I don't care what they do, what they don't. I will just think that everybody should take matters into their own hands about their lives. I'll never vote.
He'll never vote. How do we convince? Because it's no longer about the youth now. You know, people who are mushrooming and say that they're not going to vote are becoming more and more on a daily. And how do we convince them to say, guys, you need to go and vote? That one vote of yours means a lot. If you are not, if you're saying you haven't seen service delivery for years, that is a certain party. Then why don't you, you know, vote for another party, since you're not happy about the previous party that has been in power for so long, right? How do we convince people to stand up and go out there to vote next year? That's our task, me and you. That's our task.
Okay, my name is Lesegoma again.
I don't want to dwell much on who I'm going to vote for and what so not. But what I want to say is I would love to encourage young people mostly to take this thing of voting seriously. You know, they should, if they are happy with whoever they voted for in the previous elections, they need to vote for them again if they delivered on their promises. But if they did not, because South Africans have a habit of, if they're not happy with party ABC, they stay away from the polls. So I think now we need to use 2024 elections to remove the bad apples and bring in people that we think are going to deliver. And also, when politicians know that they can be removed, they'll be able to work. Unlike now, when we have a situation where people know you only see them once every 5 years, they'll just come give you bribe pack, a t-shirt with a politician with a big head, and then they know you're gonna vote for them, and then 2 days later you're gonna start burning schools and barricading road because the people that you keep bringing back are not delivering. So I hope we see a huge number of young people voting next year. As for me, I'm going to vote, but my vote is a secret.
People's votes are still secrets. Young people call it hashtag 2024 is our 1994. I'm sure you have seen that online, especially on Twitter or X. Hashtag our 2024 is our 1994. Guys, let's go out there and vote, please. Please. Out of order, do. Next voice note.
SP Dumela, ke bolela ke le Mohammed Skrale ne. Mohammed Skrale arna di old age homes tse leng re di registered man. Di teng a di registered. A di registered under Department of Health and Social Development. So is ra sokola tsentse re tse bo mama rona le bokokwa rona o krabe anong re batse ya Mohammed Skrale re ba isa bo Garankuwa, bo Atrechville, re ba isa kgole and then mo ke kolo le ha tsa motsa makapelo botlhoko because bona ka re ya molatla. So under health ba tong government ha a ge di old age homes and then tse leng re di registered government ha e funde. I register if fund the old age homes tse o bathong go be bitiri gore la wena o tsamaya o bona go kwao o ska ba le gore o travela sebaka se setelle gore o mmone le yena feel gore ba nong bana ba ha ba ha o feel yena wa e bona and then motabenya gore ke votela party ya feng eish. I'm thinking EFF, man. EFF na le tlhaloganyo tsa botsha at least. Ba le balapile, ma ANC ya lapile, di MEC tsa teng batho le di-minister ba le ba bona le ga ba tsamaya gore ba lapile batho ba o kgale ba phela le ditlhaloganyo di rusitsa di sa bereka. So ya ke nagana gore EFF e ka re zama.
Ba tinkathele, le lapile, ba re le lapile. Ra lena, ba e le gore kgale le ntse le rana, ba re lapile, o nyake ga matlanyana a ma fresh. Next voice note.
Hola, hola, Travins. Look, man. It will be that time of the year again next year, and we need to go out there in numbers and vote. My vote is not a secret. I'm voting for Action SA. Definitely. But the current government should ensure that there's no load shedding. I know they do that to lure in voters, and after that they won't care. But they need to ensure that load shedding is gone, because they are killing our economy, they are killing small businesses, and it's hard to survive out there. So yeah, load shedding, my brother.
Service delivery, Mutlakase, symbol. And he says he's voting for Action SA. So we had PA, Action SA, EFF. Are we going to get another one? Let's carry on with our voice notes.
Hi, Speedway. So since it's the elections the next day, now personally I think we need clean water, bruh. We need clean water. Not only go Amanskrala, but also in surrounding areas. I feel like Baranik Lebdaman when it comes to clean water, sanitation. And then another one, I'm not sure if all are under any mara. Taba eya di grante, but of who di grante and whatnot. I know. I think it should be stopped. And now who revampiwe di feme, who revampiwe all this building steady empty. Baba encourage batho gore ba boele back to farming, go rekisiwe fresh produce, things that we as a country can export to other countries. Let these free standing buildings man tse di senang mmereko di berekisiwe for such things. When it comes to voting, I'm not too sure gore ke nyaka go votela eng, but I know I'm not voting for the winning team. I just feel like right now I wanna vote for any other party except the ruling party. Just for Rebanse out of power and give others an opportunity. I'm all for the coalition government. But definitely not the ANC. I'm considering Action SA. And I don't know about EFF. But Action SA, definitely, I think 70% there. Otherwise, I'll be voting any other party, even the small ones, the minority ones. Ugh, my vote, as long as I go and vote and cast it to a different party, I'm definitely voting.
As long as you go and vote when I'm a girl. As long as Vince, I'm sure, but I'm going to Action SA and I'm vote. Mara ake show mara go vote. Ogari, are ake show mara hoya kaya go vote. I'm going to vote B. Not going to be. One of the ones saying hi. I'm an A. Aro vote, man. Aro vote next year, man.
Olata Vincent. The one service delivery that I wish that the government and politicians in general were to look more into is the public healthcare system. I wish we get to a point in our country where the public healthcare sector is as efficient and optimal as the private healthcare sector. There's absolutely no reason why we should be slacking in that area, because I feel like it's the most important. There are obviously other important service deliveries, but I feel that that's the most important. And next year I will be voting for the African National Congress. I mean, there's a lot of information in the public that says what is said is correct. There's also issues of corruption, but I do believe that they've got very solid policies and manifestos, and all they need to do is implement.
ANC.
Hey, what's up, Vince? The one service delivery that I would really like to see politicians providing religiously, is they would have to take charge of our SOEs, and no need to mention the biggest one that is in dire straits has to be Eskom. If they can sort out Eskom and sort it out properly, I think that's the biggest service delivery issue that I have at this point in time, because right now, in the life that we live in, the 4IR, everything runs with electricity. We've just recently seen during the duration of the Rugby World Cup what also happened. Jorge, if they do come up with a plan, things can run smoothly. Party that I'm voting for next year, just so that things may change, and I'll have to go with the DA. Though it's not my final decision as yet, because I'm scared of institutionalized racism. But hey, re tla bona ko pele. Shontwana.
Yo, sir. For me, I would like to see them creating jobs. I'd like to see more youth employed, sir. So. Job creation is number one for me. That's what I would like to see them deliver religiously. And man, it's no secret, I'm for EFF. I'm for EFF, sir.
So yeah, who are you voting for? From me, Vincent P. Peace and God bless you. Let's talk next time.